You were not there for Lucky's Outpogo Company in any way, correct?
Yes, sir.
Sabi mo rin na Secretary Roque na wala ka rin alam kung bakit sa records ng Lucky South 99 na na-retrieve ng PAOCC, eh nakalagay ang iyong pangalan bilang isang legal counsel.
Including the ownership structure of the corporation that owns the property. Have you submitted such?
I have a soft copy of the TCT with me.
Ang tanong ko po is, have you submitted?
Samahan mo ako sa pagkakaalis sa'yo after a successful operation. You have to be, you know, you are in front of the Filipino people. Masama loob mo dahil pagkatapos ng magandang operasyon, pinanggal kayo. Yes or no? Kasi malalaman natin, kung hindi masama loob mo, di okay. Masama ba loob mo? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The articles of incorporation and other relevant documents for PH2 Corporation, the corporation, as you have stated, that owns the house in Pinewood Subdivision.
Your Honor, in the last...
Sama mo kahit dalawa at least nagpa 500,000, dun ko po silang dalawa inalok. Then after po niya akong alokin ng time na yun, sabi ko, sige sir, maghahanap po muna ako ng kasama. And then comes August 2023 po, hiningian niya na po kami ng mga IDs with TIN numbers and pirma para i-validate daw po sa PAGCOR. Magkakaroon daw po ng mga investigation.
So in other words, nagkaroon kayo ng interest because hindi mo right away ni-reject yung proposal. As yes, a matter of fact, you talk to your two friends and you somehow agreed.
Yes po, Your Honor. Kasi syempre, since namamatay...
So, hindi kayo, we thought random yung pagkakapili ng pangalan nyo. But basically, sino yung kumausap sa'yo? Anong pangalan?
Mr. Dan De La Cruz po.
Fernandez.
Dan De La Cruz.
De La Cruz.
Dan De La Cruz.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, you are in contact with him until now?
Wala na po, Your Honor. Nung nalaman po namin yung mga pangalan namin na naisama po dito sa korporasyon na to, agad po namin siyang tinawagan pero hindi na po namin makontak.
Dan De La Cruz. Meron kang picture ng Dan De La Cruz?
Wala po, Your Honor.
So, matagal mo na siya kilala?
Nung pandemic time po, nagpo-post po kasi ako online nung binibenta ko pong battle tuyo. Then, doon po siya unang na-meet up kasi tumawag po siya sa akin. Then, nag-meet up po kami sa parking lot sa May Quezon City para i-deliver ko po yung goods sa kanya, sir.
Okay. Congressman Barbers.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So, lumalabas base sa kanilang sinasabi na mukhang hindi talaga identity theft. Kasi kung identity theft, hindi nyo alam, no? Meron kayong, kasi nag-submit kayo ng ID, nag-submit kayo ng TIN. So, kumbaga, para kayong nabudol. Di ba? Parang ganun yung dating.
Apo.
Okay, sige. Mr. Chair, babalikan ko na lang sila ulit later on, no? Dito naman ako sa issue tungkol sa kay General Karamat, no? Para once and for all, masettle yung issue. General Karamat, isa sa issue ay yung pagkaka-relieve ng mga tao from CIDG na nagtrabaho at nag-raid dito sa Pogo Hub na ito. Marami kasing haka-haka na ang nag-order ng kanilang relief ay ikaw. Meron naman nagsasabi na merong higher authorities ang nag-order. Meron naman din nagsasabi na mga superior mo ang nag-order, no? Para lang magkaroon ng liwanag o maliwanagan ang lahat, pwede ba sa pagkakataong ito, pakisabi nyo, sino ang nag-order ng relief ng mga taong yon?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, sir. And to all the members of this committee, fellow workers in the government, isang magandang hapon po sa ating lahat, sir. Sir, thank you for this opportunity to clarify doon, sir, sa mga pagka-relief ng mga tropa natin, sir, sa CIDG. On the part of Colonel Alejandro, ako po, sir, yung nag-relieve sa kanya. But nasabi naman ni Colonel Alejandro na before the operation in Bamban was conducted, he was already informed of the impending reshuffle nasabi na po yun ni Colonel Alejandro. Actually, hindi lang po si Colonel Alejandro yung narilim nung yung reshuffle ay naganap. Anim po sila na regional chief. At yung sinasabi nila, sir, na na-wipe up yung tao ni Colonel Alejandro, actually, dalawa lang po yung official na narilim. At na, I think nandito sila ngayon, sir. So, sila na po ang magsabi what was the reason bakit na-transfer yung dalawang official. I think I submitted already to the committee secretariat regarding dong the reasons pagka-relieve ng mga sinasabi nilang na-wipe out doon, sir, sa Region 3 nung pagkatapos ng operation, sir, sa Bamban. Another thing, sir, hindi po na-dismiss po yung kaso or RFI as was previously mentioned. Actually, sir, yung kaso ay nag-prosper at lahat ng mga suspect na napailan ng kaso ay na-issuehan po ng warrant of arrest. On the part of Colonel Buyacaw, which was another operation conducted after a year, 2024, I received a memo coming from TDPRM as I presented in the previous hearing, memo from Directorate for Personnel and Records Management directing me as the director of the CIDG to replace Colonel Buyacaw, Your Honor, sir.
Kanino ho galing yung order, General?
TDPRM, sir, Directorate for Personnel and Records Management, sir. So,
sino po ang head niyan?
It was, the OIC din was General Bakay, sir.
Okay. Sige. Thank you, General Karamat. Kay General Bakay.
Thank you, Your Honor, sir.
General, sa iyo pala galing yung order?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Magandang hapon po, Mr. Chair.
Is that because you intend to reshuffle and or there was a pending reshuffling of your men? Kaya nyo in-implement yung relief ng mga taong taga-CIDG?
Mr. Chair, the order to install Colonel Ana necessarily relieving Colonel Buyacaw came from our Chief PNP. As a matter of fact, he wanted to attend, Mr. Chair, to explain why there was a relief. The difference of time between the operation in Banban led by Colonel Buyacaw was 1 month, Mr. Chair. March 17, yung order ko po, yung memo ko was April 17, there's a 1 month lull. Meaning when General Marbil took over, during the operation, Mr. Chair, kaya po nabanggit ko si General Acorda noon because it was during his time nung nagawa yung operation sa Bamban led by Colonel Buyacaw. It was during the time of General Acorda. Nung na-relieve si Colonel Buyacaw, Mr. Chair, was the time of General Marbil. And nabanggit din po kanina ang position ng RFUNCR director. Usually, ang choice ng Chief PNP ang inuupo po yan, po dyan. Perhaps even General Acorda can attest to that, that yung nilagay niya as the RFUNCR, Colonel Buyacaw, was his choice. The same is true with General Marbil, our current Chief PNP. Si Colonel Ana ang gusto niyang maging director ng NCR RFU. It has nothing to do with the operations in Bamban led kay Colonel Buyacaw a month before, Mr. Chair. I hope that's very clear. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Salamat, General. Nandito po ba yung mga na-relieve? So, sa second round, Mr. Chair, I'd like to manifest my interest to ask questions later.
Because may I interject? Andiyan ata si Colonel Buyacaw. Andiyan ba si Colonel Buyacaw? Colonel Buyacaw, can you sit here? Baka we can ask him question na para sige, at least in relation to what you're asking.
Dito pa lang. So, Colonel Buyacaw, was the relief order a surprise to you when you received it?
Sir, I was working on another case. Kasi tapos na kami doon sa Bamban, sir. And that's the time na lumabas yung order ko, sir.
So hindi ka ba nagtaka?
Well, sir, kasi wala na si Sir Acorda na nag-install sa akin, sir. So I expect, sir, na ganun, sir, mangyari.
Bakit ine-expect po? Meron kang magandang trabaho, eh. Meron kang magandang achievement. Tapos, nirelieve ka. Anong nasa isip mo nun? Anong...
Well, sir, I believe, sir, kasi sa in the past, ang mga kwan, sir, chief sa NCR, sir, is placed by the chief PNP, sir.
Colonel,
can I interject, please?
Colonel Buyaka, masama loob mo? Yes, sir, no?
Sir, I'm just
totoo.
Police officer.
No. I'm asking you, personally. Masama loob mo sa pagkakaalis sa'yo after a successful operation. You have to be, you know, you are in front of the Filipino people. Masama loob mo dahil pagkatapos ng magandang operasyon, tinanggal kayo. Yes or no? Kasi malalaman natin, kung hindi masama loob mo, di okay. Masama ba loob mo? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Di ba? And you feel nade-demoralize kayo dahil nga successful operation nyo, tapos bigla kayong tatanggalin. Di ba? Kahit nasabihin natin that this is the practice of all these GPNPs, ano? General Acorda, during your time, was there a situation wherein there is a successful operation, then a day after, tinanggal mo silang lahat? Was there an occasion?
During my time, sir, I cannot recall such situation, sir, because talagang duly informed naman ako sa lahat sa mga operation, and except if there are some demeanors in the operation conducted, doon lang nagkakaroon ng relief, sir.
Of course,
as far as I can recall, sir, wala pong nangyaring ganun.
Of course, yun ang medyo masakit sa atin, eh, na after, ito yung hindi ko matanggap, honestly. When we have the last hearing before I recognize Congressman Chairman Acop, hindi ko matanggap na after a successful operation, sasabihin natin that alam na naman nila natatanggalin sila. Di ba? Sana hindi po ganun ang maging procedure ng PNP. And as a matter of fact, marami sa inyo na na-demoralize dahil nga inilipat sila. Let's accept it. Ayan, katulad si Colonel Buyakaw, sinasabi niya, di ba? Personally. Di ba? Masakit. Kaya, I hope, ano, before I proceed, the chair would like to recognize Congressman Chairman Acop. Chairman Acop, you have the floor.
To put things in their proper perspective, Colonel Buyakaw, nasabi mo kanina na ini-expect mo na ma-relieve ka. Tama? Nung nawala si General Acorda.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Bakit?
Sir, as I said a while ago, sir, as experience yung napansin ko, sir, in the past, kung sino, sir, yung chief PNP, siya, sir, yung naglalagay.
Yes, sir. Retired na ako. I retired in 2001, 23 years. Nung ako rin ang nag-chief ng NCR CIS, ang chief PNP ang nagpumipili kung sino ang maging boss dyan. Diba? Kaya ikaw ang pinili ni General Acorda. Right? Tapos nung naupo si General Marvel, nirelieve ka kasi siya ang pipili ng uupo dun sa unit na yan. That's been the tradition. Tama?
Yes, sir. Yes.
O kaya dapat hindi sumamalob mo dahil alam mo na yun ang tradition, eh. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I continue.
Okay, so the chair of Dangerous Drugs, Chairman Ace Barbers.
Thank you,
Mr. Patuloy mo.
So, balikan na lang natin yung sa issue sa Philippine National Police. Ano? Gusto ko lang matanong yung PDEA. Is PDEA present?
Yes. Si Director Lasso.
Director General Lasso, mula nang nag-umpisa yung mga congressional hearings ng dangerous drugs, public order, public accounts, at saka yung Committee on Human Rights, there seems to be a common denominator doon sa usaping yon, no? At hindi nawawala yung usapin tungkol sa drugs. Do you have any information that you wish to share to the committee with respect to perhaps your findings or your mga datos na nandiyan dyan sa inyo, Director General Lasso?
Yes, Your Honors. This is our first time, for PDEA to join this hearing. We have been actively participating in the committees on the EJK hearings and the Committee on Dangerous Drugs. In the hearings that we joined, we took note of the matrices or diagrams that were presented during these hearings, and when we went back to our office, we crafted a better diagram on how it can be clearly seen how they are connected with each other. And after we made that diagram, I shared it with PAOCC, Yusek Gilbert Cruz. Because inputted in that diagram is that there was a report which came out of the Senate hearings that a certain brother of Michael Young, can I just refer to my... A certain brother of Michael Young, who is Hu Jiang Yang, also known as Yang Hung Jiang, is an incorporator or part of Pulwin Group of Companies. And Paili Estate Group Corporation. Now, in the hearings of the Senate, it was revealed that Baofu Land Development Incorporated, wherein Mayor Alice Leal Go is an incorporator, received money from the joint account of Yang's brother, Hong Jiang Yang, and one, Yu Zeng Kan. Supposed to be, or reportedly, this money was used to bankroll Hongsheng Gaming Technology, the builder of Pogo Complex in Banpan, raided in March 13, Your Honors. And so, again, these are not part of our holdings. We just collated what we heard from Congress and from the Senate, and came up with this diagram. And that's where we saw the connection of Mayor Go and Hong Jiang Yang, a brother of Michael Yang.
Okay, thank you, DG. Other than that information, wala nang ibang link or connection?
No more, Your Honor.
Okay. Sige, thank you, DG. Now I'd like to ask, direct my questions to a former colleague, Secretary Harry Roque. Alam ko, pagod ka na, Secretary, dahil you've been asked questions and some of those questions are repeatedly asked. No? Ako, for my sake and for my education and my enlightenment as well, I'd like to ask you questions that are very... quick and very answerable only by yes or no. Is that okay?
Yes, Mr. Okay. Chair.
So, you said that you went to PAGCOR to accompany Ms. Cassandra Ong as a representative of Whirlwind Corporation.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. You were not there for Lucky South Pogo Company in any way, correct?
Yes, sir. I had no contacts at all with Lucky Star South.
Okay. Lucky South 99, no?
Yes, Your Honor. Okay.
Is Whirlwind a Pogo company?
No, Mr. Chair.
Does Whirlwind have any transactions with PAGCOR?
No, Mr. Chair.
You also testified that with Whirlwind, that Whirlwind is a company that owns the land where Lucky South 99 Pogo is situated, correct?
They don't own the land. They lease the land and they own the buildings.
So they lease the land... from
Cruz family.
From Cruz family. Okay, thank you. So, Whirlwind has a lease agreement with Lucky South, correct?
Yes, Mr. Chair, yes.
Now, does the lease agreement need PAGCOR's approval for validity?
I have no information, Your Honor, if that is required.
Now, is PAGCOR a party to the lease agreement?
No, Your Honor.
The lease agreement is a private contract between Whirlwind and Lucky South 99. Years of Lucky South 99 that it owes to PAGCOR.
Yes, they did, Your Honor.
Did they also discuss the application of Lucky South 99 with PAGCOR?
Only to the extent that there are new guidelines to be issued for internet gambling, and in that meeting, they were given, in fact, a copy of the new guidelines.
And the new guidelines was not present when the time that Lucky South 99 had its first license.
Yes, Your Honor. In fact, it had only been released in the same month of the meeting in the month of July. It was brand new, so to speak.
Okay. Now, days after that meeting in PAGCOR, did you call Attorney Fernandez of PAGCOR to follow up on the lease contract of Whirlwind and Lucky South?
Not days, months.
Months.
Oh, yeah. It was February. Okay. February when I asked for what other lacking documents were required. Okay. So it was around February, okay. If I'm not mistaken, Attorney Jezza. And it wasn't a call, it was just a text.
Okay. Did you call Attorney Fernandez several times to follow up on the application of Lucky South with PAGCOR?
No, Your Honor. Once I called to relay the message that Lucky South had hired a lawyer to prepare a requirement, MTPP, and then a third time I texted to ask what is the status of the application.
Okay. So, sabi mo rin na Secretary Roque na wala ka rin alam kung bakit sa records ng Lucky South 99 na na-retrieve ng PAOCC, nakalagay ang iyong pangalan bilang isang legal counsel.
Yes, that's
correct.
That is correct, Your Honor.
Okay. Now, did you initiate a filing of a case against the Lucky South 99 for including your name without your consent?
No, Your Honor, because the first time I found out about it was in the Senate hearing, which was only last month.
And I believe that after the PAOCC raided the Lucky South 99, and upon discovery of this document, they came out with a press statement, press conference, showing that there is a document which bears the name of Attorney Harry Roque there. You're not aware of that?
I was aware of my name in the Senate hearing. It was Senator Risa Ontiveros that brought it out, okay. Your Honor.
Salamat, Secretary Harry Roque. And I also remember that you mentioned in both hearings, both in the Senate and in the House, that you used to stay in that house in Tuba, Benguet.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. The Tuba house in Benguet is owned by PH2. Corporation.
Yes, Your Honor.
Is that correct? So when you stayed in that house, Secretary Harry Roque, did you have to lease it with the PH2 Corporation?
No, Your Honor.
You did not?
I did not.
And when you left the house, you had it leased to a certain Yuan?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yuan? Is there a lease agreement between...
Yes, Your Honor. I submitted it to this committee,
okay,
Your Honor.
There was a submission, OMSEC, no? So... yung bang rental income that you made, the PH2 gained from that lease agreement between Yawa, Yawan and PH2, where you are an incorporator, am I correct?
I am not an incorporator in PH2. I'm an incorporator in Biansham, which in turn owns. Yes, Your Honor.
So did you reflect this, I suppose, in your salen?
Well, it was only for the year, Your Honor. It was not leased when I was in government. So okay. It was leased after I was already in government. So it was not reflected in salen, Your Honor.
Okay, thank you. Maraming salamat, Mr. Chair. And siguro to give time to others as well, I just would like to manifest that in the second round, this representation would like to ask questions again. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
You want to be included in the second round? Are you sure?
Congressman Abante. Ano pala? Sige, Congressman Abante. Before you... Sige, ikaw na muna nga. Huli na naman ako. Sige. Oh, okay. Second round muna to, di ba?
Yes.
So, I'll be asking muna ako muna. So, I'll be asking yung...
Ikaw na muna.
Because this is your second round, di ba?
Ha? Yeah, your second round.
So, let's I'm now the next. Allow muna yung mga... May tanong lang ako sa ano? Sa PIDEA. PIDEA, General Lasso, have you encountered yung mga companies? You have coordination with PAOK already, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Meron na tayong mga coordination.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Chairman Akop.
I was about to give my time to the Honorable Abante kasi meron lang daw siyang tatanungin sa kapulisan. But since question yun na second round na pala siya, ako po ay hindi pa nakaka-first round. Pwede po bang mag-first round mo?
Okay. Oh, Congressman Akop, I thought Congressman Akop will not be asking question. But you are now recognized, Chairman Akop. Mamaya na tayo, General Lasso, ha? Okay.
Thank you. May asked Secretary Roque, in the last hearing, you were required to submit to this committee the documentations confirming the ownership of the house in Pinewood subdivision, including the ownership structure of the corporation that owns the property. Have you submitted such?
I have a copy, a soft copy of the TCT.
Ang tanong ko po is, have you submitted such?
Hindi po, but I can submit po.
Thank you. Do you also, have you all already submitted a copy of the lease contract between Yun Wan and his wife and your wife, Madam Myla Roque?
Yes, Your Honor.
Submitted already?
Submitted already, Your Honor.
Thank you. Have you already submitted the articles of incorporation and other relevant documents for PH2 Corporation, the corporation, as you have stated, that owns the house in Pinewood subdivision?
Your Honor, in the last meeting, Congressman Paduana said that it should be the SEC that should furnish this committee with those articles.
That's what...